Hi everyone, I'm Jade. Today we're talking about Greek words in English. And I'm not teaching you these words because they'll be the most useful words for you. I'm not teaching you these words so you can go around sounding really clever using long words when you're speaking English. The reason is to show you a little bit about how the English language has evolved. And also so that when you do encounter a long word, you can use what I'm teaching you today to break it down, and maybe you'll recognize parts of this word and that will help you understand. So let's have a look at some Greek words in English. So most of the time when we find a Greek word in English, it's academic language, it represents a concept or idea, and there will be quite a lot of medical language as well. So looking at medical words for the mind and body, The Greeks from a long time ago, they were very knowledgeable about medicine and things like that. So we took a lot of words from their language. We didn't have we didn't have words for these things because it was not knowledge known here. So the concepts came from Greece, and with that, the language came from Greece. So when we find a word with dermo or derma in it, we need to think of this part of the word as a building block. And you put different building blocks together, and that can help you understand the whole meaning of the word, otherwise known as a root. So that means skin. And when we get this end part of the word, which sounds like ology, that means study of a subject. So skin, study of the skin, you put it together and that gives you the full meaning. So if you have a problem with your skin and you need to go to hospital, you would go to the dermatology department, and the doctor would be a dermatologist, a special doctor who knows about skin problems. A different skin problem is dermatitis, and the titus part means inflammation. It means could be swollen skin, or could be inside your body. If it's a problem with your bones, you get a disease called arthritis that older people get usually, and it's quite painful and difficult to move their fingers and things like that. So these are examples of medical words. You can sometimes get a sense of what one part means and maybe guess the other. Similarly, when we get words with hemo or hema, this is related to blood. Hemoglobin is a part of what makes up our blood. Hematoma is the medical word for bruise. You know, when you hit yourself and the skin goes purple, if it's a big bruise, then it's a hematoma. And a hemorrhage is a medical problem where blood is suddenly like leaking out where it's not meant to be inside your body, and you can be in very big trouble if you get a hemorrhage. Sometimes people get a brain hemorrhage and maybe they die from that. So hemo or hema means blood. What about psycho or psych? What does this mean? Well, this is to do with the mind. And I think these words are interesting because we can see how they're related. So we have psychic, that's the power of being able to read somebody's mind, one mind to another mind. Psycho means like crazy. And psychiatrist means doctor of the mind. So whenever you see a word with this, you know it's to do with the mind, basically. That's a useful one, I think. You can find that in a lot of words. Then let's have a look at words with mania. You'll find words with mania at the end. Mania means to be mad or addicted to something. So here are two words. Kleptomania means somebody addicted to stealing things, thief. They can't help themselves but steal things. And nymphomania means somebody addicted to sex, somebody who can't help themselves from having sex. but that we've got many, many words with this mania on the end. So if you see that, you can get a sense again of what it actually means. And we've got words here, anthropo, and that means human, related to human things. Anthropology, do you remember what this part means? The study of humans. So an anthropologist is somebody who studies the way people live and society and culture in the world. And anthropomorphic, you might use this if you're a kind of literature student or something. This is a word for when we make things that aren't humans, we talk about things that aren't humans as if they were. So when you put a little puppy dog in human clothes and you start talking to it like it's a person, you're anthropomorphizing the little dog. But it's an anthropomorphic behavior to dress up a little puppy dog like that. Very long, complicated words, I know. But we can break it down a little bit more. When you see IC on the end, it means it's an adjective and we're describing something. So when we come back, we'll look at the next Greek roots, Greek words I want to show you. Let's take a look at more Greek words in English. We'll start with words with phone or phony in them. Of course, we've got the phone that we use, and this root means sound. Phone is the informal word for telephone. And this word, cacophony, I'll never forget this word, because when I was at school, we wrote, you write stories. I think I was quite young when this happened, and somebody else's story was read out, and she used the word cacophony in it, and I was so jealous. I was like, that's a really long word and you sound really clever. So I think I tried to like use it in every single story I wrote after then. But it means like having very loud different sounds that go together, and it's like it's an unpleasant sort of noise basically. So anyway, I won't forget that word. And also I remember that learning that this part of the word means string when I was at school as well, because poly, we see this in lots of words, like polyester is a kind of plastic, or when you go to the shop and they give you a plastic bag, that one's polythene bag. And I remember being at school and my science teacher telling me that poly means string, because if you think about how plastic is made, it's different atoms stringing together, and I'm getting a bit science, we're talking about the English language here anyway. So it's string meaning different things together basically. So that's what all plastics are. Here's a word, polyamorous. So we've got more than one, and this root amor is related to love, and what this word means is relationships where they're like open relationships and people can have more than one partner, polyamorous love, different lovers. Looking on this side for more technological words, we've got tele. I already mentioned telephone, but the tele part means distant or far away. So we have telephone, communicating with someone who's not physically near you, someone who's far away. Telepathy is also communicating with someone who is not with you. They can be with you, but it's just through the mind communication. And teleport, which as far as I know hasn't been invented yet, but it would be really cool. It's when you can travel to one place just like that, basically. To be in a different place. You don't need planes, you don't need buses, you don't need Oyster cards. You can just go using a teleport. But we haven't managed to invent that one yet. And micro, this root means small. So we've got microchip. You find these in laptops, any kind of electronic device. It's where all the information. This is again like a science lesson. I'm not going to explain what a microchip is, except that it makes electronic things work. I think is a good way to explain it. And microcosm means something small within something bigger. So one way people talk about it, mostly I find, is when talking about the weather. So like in the UK, we don't have many places with good weather, but some places are described as being microcosms, like some particular beaches are more, seem to be sunnier than the general places in England, not as much rain, things like that. So those places would be described as microcosms of the bigger, you know, the surrounding climate, which is generally rainy. We can also thank the Greeks for analytical words, like they were measuring things. Probably we weren't measuring things then, I don't know. But from the metric system, we have the word kilo and related words. This means 1,000 of something. So kilometer is 1,000 meters, and kilogram is 1,000 grams. So this one is for distance and this one is for measurement. Then you've probably seen geo in some words, and that root means the earth and things related to the planet where we live. So we've got geography, which is another school science. It's about learning about our world and how it's made up. And geology, which is the study of rocks, stones, that kind of thing. So, yeah, here are some Greek words for you. Now, just paying attention to roots can really help you develop your vocabulary as you just start to guess things. You don't have to check the meaning of every word that you encounter. You can go to the İngilizce website, do a quiz on this lesson, test out your vocabulary brain power. And if you like this lesson, please subscribe. I've got all different kinds of lessons on my İngilizce channel, not just about really long words that you might not ever use when you're speaking. I've also got my personal channel. There's lots and lots of videos on my personal channel, so I want you to go and check that out too. And yeah, I'm finished. So I'm going to go and swallow a dictionary now and learn some really complicated words. So see you later. Bye.